The sting from that insect was electric in nature, and it was probably the worst 5 minutes of my life at that point.
Yeah, that's exactly why I call it electrifying. I say, you want to be macho? Oh, I'm tough, I can overdo this. No, you can't. So I tell people, lay down and scream.
People often ask me, Coyote, how many times have you been stung? And my answer, when I look back to the beginning, from harvester ants, to fire ants, to honeybees, to the cow killer, tarantula hawk, and bullet ant, is many times. In fact, well over 250 times since my climb up the insect sting pain index began. However, while many people have coined me the king of sting, this incredible journey actually began with a well-cartographed map, created by a man who I consider to not only be the true king, but the actual godfather of everything that is insect stings, Justin Schmidt. A world-renowned entomologist and author, he has documented the sting pain of over 80 insect species. And today, for the first time ever, I am getting the chance to sit down and talk with him face-to-face about his climb up the index and how our collective experiences have helped bring a new fascination to the world of bugs.
So this is the guy who made the index.
This is it. He inspired that climb all the way up through the velvet ant, the tarantula hawk, and ultimately the bullet ant. Oh, I don't know if I'm more nervous now than I ever have been to meet somebody in my life. Are you guys ready?
I'm ready. Let's do this.
All right, now here's what's going to happen. I'm going to knock on that door, and either there's going to be Justin Schmidt inside, and we're going to be talking bugs, or there's going to be a bunch of stinging insects that come out, and it's going to be a big hoax. You ready?
Mario, I don't know.
I'm excited, nervous, I don't know.
Godfather himself.
I've seen you before.
Oh, and I have seen you, read the book. I know absolutely everything here. Let's move in, let the camera crew come in.
This is a news crew, Coyote? There's a whole team here.
We've got an entire team today filming a separate documentary. Hold on a second. I gotta just take a 360 here and absorb. This is where it all comes from. Wow. This is pretty cool. Today's gonna be really interesting. I'm gonna be sitting down with Justin to talk about our journey up the insect sting pain index. As you guys know, all my inspiration has come from this man right here. We also have another crew with us today that's filming a separate documentary. Say hi, guys.
Hello.
So we have all sorts of cameras going today. I don't know where this is gonna lead to, but it's gonna be exciting, and there's gonna be so much knowledge coming out of this. I just can't wait to sit down, pick your brain about what has inspired you to get stung by things, because I know where my inspiration came from, but what you've
done?
Same
for I want to know what inspired you, because you know we have very different output attitudes, very different means, but I think the goals are the same.
Exactly.
And that's what's so beautiful. We're trying to stimulate an interest and love of science and biology and just life.
Yes.
It's
cool. And bugs. People are always so afraid of bugs, but they don't need to be afraid of these creatures.
Exactly.
They're beautiful and they're amazing and they do such wonderful things for the environment, and the more that we can educate people about them,
exactly,
the better off the world is gonna be.
Ready to start the conversation? 3, 2, 1, action.
All right, guys, well, this has been a long time coming. My chance to actually sit down with who I consider the godfather of the insect sting pain index, the one and only Justin Schmidt. And we are inside of his research office slash lab today. What we're gonna do now is just have a back and forth conversation about what this journey has been like for both of us. I mean, I think it's fair to say that you've been stung by more creatures than I have. I've read your book, and it's incredible. And I actually, to be honest, read the book partway through climbing the insect sting pain index. And I was turned on to the sting of the wild after I was actually stung by harvester ants, which maybe is a great place for us to start, considering we're here in the Sonoran Desert, which is the home of the one and only harvester ant. Now, you've been stung by harvester ants before,
exactly,
right?
And in fact, just like what you said, the harvester ant is what got the sting pain scale going in the first place.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'd been stung by honeybees, yellow jackets, you know, paper wasps.
Yeah, the normal things in your backyard.
Yeah, the garden variety stuff that you get bitten by various beetles and things. I went down to Georgia, which has the easternmost extension of the harvester ant.
Mm-hmm.
I got stung by one. Whoa!
Didn't see that coming, right?
This is different. You know, I thought I knew everything there was about stinging insects. You know, I was just this dumb little kid.
Yeah.
Said, hey, wait a minute, there's something different going on here. And that's what got me doing the comparative. Is this unique to harvest ants, or are there others that are like that? Mm-hmm. And it turns out, well, the answer is now we know much later, it's unique.
Mm-hmm. Well, and for me, where it began, you know, without even knowing about the insect sting pain index, we were here filming in Arizona, and we were getting ready to film in my mom's backyard, who lives right here in Tucson. And she said, when you go out there, watch out for the harvest ant nest, because I got stung by one the other day, and man, did it give me a wall.
Hurt.
And I was like, an ant gave you a really painful sting. So we went out, we looked at this, you know, mound in the ground. Well, it's flat, you know, you got the hole and all the ants pouring out, and we were like, well, let's find out how painful that sting really is. So we did a little research, and we were like, okay, well, no one's ever died from being stung by a harvest ant, but let's see what happens when I take a bunch of stings. So, you know, just kind of on a whim, I said, let's set up the cameras, and I put both of my hands down in, and before I knew it, just hundreds of ants swarming my arms. And I took around, what was it, like 50 or 60 stings.
Yeah.
60
wow.
stings from the harvester ants, and it
you
was bad.
The world record.
I don't know, but
most,
it was.
Most of us give up after one sting.
Yeah, well, what I tried to do was last 60 seconds with my hands in the nest of harvester ants. And
wow.
I did actually make it to 60 seconds. And long story short, we ended up releasing this episode. We didn't know how the audience would take it. And all of a sudden, everybody starts talking about Justin Schmidt and the insect sting pain index.
Cool.
And are you gonna get stung by a bullet ant? And I said to myself, I don't
even
know what
a bullet ant
was.
Yeah.
I was like, a bullet ant? This sounds like a made up creature, right?
You don't wanna know.
So I looked up your work, and lo and behold, I find this picture of you with an ant on your nose, an ant the size of your thumb. And I'm thinking to myself, this has gotta be Photoshopped, right? So I dig a little deeper, and sure enough, the legend is true, the bullet ant is real. And that's when I end up stumbling upon your insect sting pain index, which was just this beautiful chart of all these different bugs ranked on a scale of 1 to 4 based on least amount of pain to worst amount of pain.
Exactly.
Right? And so what inspired you? I mean, I think it's clear that, you know, we've established that you've inspired me, and we'll get into more of that in a second, but what would ever say to you, let's go out and just get stung by things for fun?
Well, I didn't really want to go out and get stung for fun. I was this desperate graduate student mm-hmm. trying to get a thesis so I could get out and get a real job, you know, stop being a student eventually. Mm-hmm. And I realized that, oh, we can measure toxicity, you know, how much killing power something has, but we can't measure pain. Ouch, that one hurts. Ouch, that one hurts. That one over there hurts. Ouch. But I can't put that into a computer program, mathematically analyze
right.
what it means for the insect. So I said, ah, we need a pain scale. A computer can analyze 1, 2, 3, and 4.
Mm-hmm.
Can't analyze ouch. So I decided that I had to make a pain scale. The harvester ant, make it to cut to the chase, was a 3.
Mm-hmm.
Honeybee is a 2.
Mm-hmm.
And I kind of tell people that each number is like 10 equivalents of the number before. So like 10 honeybee stings would equal 1 harvester ant
right.
sting. 10 harvester ant stings would equal 1 bullet ant sting.
Mm-hmm.
So you got 6 bullet ant stings when you plunged your hands into that
yeah.
equivalent. So that would be a 4.5, I guess, if you wanted to extrapolate beyond 4.
Yeah, it was extreme. It certainly woke me up. And I think what's interesting is that you create this index so that everybody out there can understand these insects a little bit better, and then certainly respect them on this scale of pain. And for us, it's always been about, you know, let me put myself in the guinea pig situation, and we always encourage people never to try this, which, you know, I know you always encourage as well. Putting yourself into the test field is one thing, but you never know how your body's going to react to any of these venoms. So, you know, as you started with the harvester ants and then you started figuring out some of these other creatures, were you ever nervous to take a sting where you're like, okay, what if this is the one that sends me into anaphylactic shock? What kind of went through your head as you
yeah,
were getting
I never
to that?
Worried about the medical aspects.
Mm-hmm.
I actually didn't even worry about the pain, because, you know, when you're in the thick of the battle, if you're focused on something like pain, you can't do the battle right.
Right.
And there's this wasp nest up in the tree. I may never see this wasp nest again. I got to get this thing, because that's a data point. A data point's important. There aren't very many of them in my field. I got 60. That took 30 years to get 60 or so.
Wow.
Or 80, I guess it is now. But the other thing that I kind of relied on is, well, it's only 1% of people have an allergic reaction, and only 1% of those have really dire reactions
mm-hmm.
where you're likely to die. You just get skin reactions and that sort of thing. I say, well, I'm walking across the street, I could get run over by the bus or the truck.
Mm-hmm.
That's probably as risky as it is out there.
That's what I always say.
Or actually, the other things I worry about, strangely, are the mosquitoes.
The mosquitoes are a really good thing to mention, because one thing that a lot of people kind of don't understand is there's a big difference between a bite and a sting. Now, a mosquito is a bite, and a lot of what we have experienced are stings. Now, we know I've been bitten by lots of other things like snapping turtles and alligators and whatnot, but the sting is something that's very different because it's venom being injected into your body. And I know for me specifically, probably one of the scariest instances I ever had, which is something that's lower down on the sting index as a 2, being the honeybee, I was stung 30 plus times in the face by honeybees by wearing a bee beard. My face swelled up like a giant potato, and I'd never been stung by honeybees before, so I was nervous that my body would have some sort of negative reaction. And when people ask me, well, what was the most painful sting you've ever taken? Of course, it is the bullet ant, but when you, exactly like you said, when you've got multiple stings in one region, especially on your face, that was a pretty painful day.
You can't see, and your nose is dripping, and your lips are swollen up, so you can't eat.
Yep.
Yeah, honeybees are actually, I consider, the most dangerous of the stinging insects because there's so many of them.
Right.
I mean, you get a bullet ant, there's maybe 2,000 or 3,000 of them in the biggest colony, but you only get a couple dozen that come out.
Right.
And they can't fly.
Right.
That's a big difference. Mm-hmm. If you can fly,
you can run away pretty quickly and get away from the bullet ants.
You can't run away from bees nearly as easily.
Right.
And, you know, if you have 50, 60,000 of these things and they're out to get you, boy. You know, that's a really scary thing.
So in line of flying stinging insects, or some that crawl along the ground, let's jump straight into the tarantula hawk, another one of the large flying stinging creatures of our planet that can be found here in the Sonoran Desert. For me, the tarantula hawk almost put a line in the sand, no pun intended, when it came to completing the sting index, because I will never forget what it was like. First of all, how intimidating that creature is to get that thing in the entomology forceps, and it looks like
and
an alien. It is strong, the wings are going, and you see that quarter inch stinger coming in and out of that abdomen. And that moment where I'm like, all right, I'm gonna have to place this on my forearm and take this sting. And when I finally worked up the courage to do that, the sting from that insect was electric in nature. I've been shocked before by accidentally, like, you know, taking a zap from like a,
oh, yeah,
a electrical cord, right? This was that times 10, and it put me on the ground. My arm seized up from muscle contraction, and it was probably the worst 5 minutes of my life at that point.
Yeah, that's exactly why I call it electrifying. I say, imagine you're walking along in Arizona, and there's a windstorm, and the power line above and the telephone pole snaps the wire and it hits you. That's what, of course, that hasn't happened to me.
Right.
But, you know, that's what you imagine it feels like. It's just absolutely electrifying. I call it debilitating, because you want to be macho. Oh, I'm tough. I can overdo this. No, you can't. So I tell people, lay down and scream.
That's what I did. And Mark would be like, you know, his famous line, Coyote, are you okay? Are you okay? And it was very hard to compose myself to be like, all right, describe what's happening to your body right now. Because your mind goes into this state that's just, it's blank emptiness. And all you can focus on is the fact that there's radiating pain coming out of your
arm. That's why you scream, because now you're focusing on something else.
Yeah.
In addition to the pain, you're focusing on, well, that's taking a little bit of the juice.
That's a pretty good impression.
That's a good.
A little bit of the juice off of the pain.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe you can lower it down to a 3 for as long as you can yell.
Right.
And I can yell for a pretty long time when I'm stung by a tarantula hawk.
Well, for me, the tarantula hawk was interesting as compared to the velvet ant, is that it was 5 minutes of intense pain, and then just like a light switch, it turned off. And I was like, you could actually breathe again. And, you know, it's important to know that something like a tarantula hawk is not out there trying to sting people. They are actually very peaceful creatures. They are looking for nectar. And unless you're a tarantula, you really don't have anything to fear unless you're going to go up and try to catch one of these insects. So I'd say your odds of being stung by a tarantula hawk are slim to none unless you're really antagonizing it.
I don't know if anybody's ever been stung by one except entomologists trying to catch them. They get them in the net. This is a powerful thing. As you know, it's hard to get it out of the net.
Yeah.
You're trying to get it out, and well, sooner or later you're going to make a mistake, and that long stinger isn't very forgiving.
Right. Oh, and they're incredibly agile too, the way that they can just swing their body and tuck their abdomen under, and before you know it, they've grasped on those with those little hooked legs, and boom, you get a sting.
They're grabbing tarantulas. If you grab the tarantula, you can certainly deal with an entomologist.
Absolutely.
Entomologists are much simpler than a tarantula.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think, Justin? Do you think, you feel like it's about the same experience you had?
Well, I think the beauty of what we're both doing is we're trying to make education and knowledge and love for insects and life in general as our ultimate goals, that we want to inspire people through entertainment, And facts and entertainment don't have to be in conflict.
Right.
They go together. And I think we're both trying to do this the same way.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. And it's a matter of admiring these animals from a respectful distance in all instances. And a lot of people ask me, well, why are you stung by these things? Why do you want to go through this pain? It's so that we can get an education about these animals, so that we learn about the science, and so that people understand that these creatures are not out there to simply get you. We put ourselves into these positions so that we can explain to the audience what it's like to go through this pain. And when you see how bad it is and you hear how bad it is, hopefully you will just say, okay, yep, that's a bullet ant over there. I'm gonna zoom in with my camera and get a photo from here.
And you'll learn about their biology so that you don't get stung. Mm-hmm. If you know the biology, like I can pick up a tarantula hawk by letting it crawl on me, mm-hmm. because I'm not threatening it. I come in and pick it up like this, yep. and I'll get stung. Well, that's knowledge of the biology.
Right. Well, on behalf of myself, my team, and everybody out there watching, we have to say thank you for creating the Insect Sting Pain Index, because without the groundwork you laid, we would not have the roadmap to follow that ultimately led to us creating all of this wonderful edutainment that now everybody knows more about these insects, how to approach them in the wild, safely respect them from a distance, and then of course, just have a love for these creatures that are oftentimes misunderstood. So Justin, thank you so much for inviting us into your incredible office today, for sharing with us all this knowledge. Of course, guys, make sure to check out Justin's book, The Sting of the Wild. It is absolutely fascinating. The bullet ant chapter is my favorite. I'm Coyote Peterson. Be brave, stay wild. We'll see you on the next location.
If you are looking for an incredibly fascinating book, I highly recommend The Sting of the Wild, which chronicles the best of Justin's painful insect encounters. In fact, I consider my autographed copy to be one of the most treasured manuscripts I own. Over the course of my career, I have met some captivating individuals. Yet when it comes to someone who can swap sting stories and the painful journey that it took to chronicle them, no one compares to the godfather of sting himself, the one and only Justin Schmidt. If you thought this episode was an interesting look into the history of the Insect Sting Pain Index, make sure to go back and watch what Justin and I both agree is the most painful, the sting of the bullet ant. And don't forget, subscribe so you can join me and the crew on our next big adventure.
Oh, it's stuck in my arm! It's stuck in my arm! Oh, the stinger is stuck in my arm! Look at that! Oh, okay, it's off! It's off! It's off! Oh my gosh!